Hello dear students, let us continue with your previous class grammar portion. Last class we just had a brief introduction about your second chapter, that is present tense. We saw that the present tense, it has got four forms. The first is simple present tense, next present continuous, third present perfect, and present perfect continuous tense, right? So we just saw some of the points, some of the uses where we can use the simple present tense, and we also saw that simple present tense is also known as indefinite tense, correct? So today let us see what do you mean by present continuous tense, and how can we say that a sentence, whether it is in simple present tense or it is in present continuous form. So present continuous form is formed with is, are, am, plus the first form, okay, along with its ing. And if you want to write a negative sentence in a present continuous tense, then you just have to put not. But where you have to put not? You have to put the word not after is or are or am. And supposingly if you want to write an interrogative sentence in a present continuous form, then you just have to place is, are, am before the subject. That's all. So I repeat this three line, okay? If you want to form a simple present continuous tense sentence, then you just have to add is, are, am plus first form plus ing. If you want to form a negative sentence in a present continuous tense, then you have to form by putting not after the word is, are, or am. And supposingly if you want to form an interrogative sentence, then you have to place is, are, am before the subject. Alright, if you see in your text page number 17, there's a table given about the present continuous tense, how to form a present continuous tense. Also you will see that how to form a negative sentence in a present continuous tense and also an interrogative sentence. Now let us see some of the uses of present continuous tense. The first point that we have to keep in mind while writing or while forming a present continuous tense is that present continuous tense is used to express an action which is happening right now at the time of speaking. Okay, like supposedly we are speaking right now, so with an action which is taking place right now. For example, I am reading a letter, or another example, someone is knocking at the door. That means these actions are taking place right now when I am talking about these actions. Secondly, present continuous tense is also used to express a temporary action which may not be happening at the time of speaking. For example, these days we are looking for a new house. So see, now I'm telling you that these days we are looking for a new house, but it doesn't mean that when I'm telling you about this particular thing, I am also looking for this right now at the moment. No, right now it may not be happening, but it is, I'm using this word in a present continuous form just to say, to express a temporary action. Okay, another example, she is teaching English at a high school. So when I say she is teaching or he is teaching or whosoever, that means that person is teaching English. But that doesn't mean that when I'm telling you, right at that moment that person was teaching or that person is teaching. Nothing like that. Next, the third point where to use the present continuous tense is that to express a definite arrangement in the near future. Okay? Something you have already arranged about it and which is going to happen in the near future. For example, I am meeting him tonight. So see, still I did not meet him, I am about to meet him, right? I am meeting him. So something which is going to happen in the near future, that is tonight. I am going to America next week, right? So here in this, the time of action must be mentioned in these cases, in such type of sentences where you are talking about something which is going to happen in the near future. In that particular sentence, you must mention the time. For example, say, as I told you that I am meeting him. If I say I am meeting him, when am I meeting him? Am I meeting him in the morning, in the afternoon, at night? So I am meeting him tonight. So the time is specifically mentioned. If you look at this next example which I gave you, I am going to America next week. When am I going to? Am I going to America tomorrow or today in the evening or day after tomorrow? It's clearly specifically mentioned that next week. Also, present tense or present continuous tense is used to express some undesirable habit. For example, she is always wasting her time in gossips. So it's an undesirable habit. Now, something which you have to take note of is that We use simple present tense for things in general. Alright? We use present continuous tense to express things going on at the time of speaking. I repeat, okay, there's the difference between simple present and present continuous. Simple present we use for things which are in general, but whereas present continuous we use to express actions going on at the time of speaking. Okay, for example, if you look in your page 18, it's beautifully given the example. Sachin Tendulkar is a famous cricketer. He plays very well, but he isn't playing now. So see, Sachin Tendulkar is a famous cricketer. Okay, now you look at the second sentence. He plays very well. So the word plays is a simple present tense. But look at the next sentence. But he isn't playing now. So playing, plays become playing. Simple present transforming into present continuous tense. Okay. Next sentence, another thing which is given in your book, he is watching television. Watching, the word watching becomes present continuous. So verbs are normally not used in present continuous tense. All right. Now, some verbs are normally not used in present continuous tense, and you have to take note of those verbs. Verbs of senses, for example, see, hear, smell, notice, recognize. Verbs of emotions and feelings, such as want, desire, love, hate, forgive, wish, respect, and etc. Also, verbs of thinking, such as think, feel, know, mean, realize, understand, suppose, believe, remember, forget. Verbs expressing possession and belonging, right? Possession, as we have already discussed in the previous chapter, determiner, the possessive, so possession, such as have, own, belong, possess, etc. And some other verbs like seem, appear, contend, consist, keep, measure, etc. These verbs are used in simple present tense. I repeat, these verbs which we have discussed just right now, verbs of senses, verbs of emotions and feelings, verbs of thinking, verbs of expressing possession or belonging, and some other verbs such as seem, appear, contend, consist, keep, measures, these are always used in simple present tense. They may, however, be used in a continuous tense with a changed meaning. Okay, so these verbs can be used in a continuous tense but with a changed meaning. For example, the judge is hearing the case tomorrow. So here, the word hearing, it doesn't refer to verb of senses. The judge is hearing the case tomorrow. Here, the word hearing refers to trial in a court. All right, you look at another example. Archit is having his bath. So here the word having, okay, doesn't refer to your verbs of possession or verbs of belonging. Here it refers to taking, that Archit is taking his bath. So Archit is having his bath. So these words, as I told you, it can be used in a continuous tense form, but however, the meaning changes. All right. So go through this present continuous tense form properly. And the next class, we shall see the remaining two forms of present tense, that is present perfect and present perfect continuous. Okay, go through the text. In case if you have any doubt, you may get back to me. Thank you.